Hello students, so in today's video we are going to discuss the topic law of demand. So let us start with the topic. It states that other things remaining the same, the quantity demanded of a commodity increases when its price decreases and vice versa, which means when other things are constant or when other things does not changes, the quantity demanded of a commodity increases when the price decreases. When the price of a commodity is high, then we will demand less of that commodity. And when the price of a commodity will be low, then we will demand more of that commodity. Okay. So this is what the law of demand states. Thus, the law indicates that there is an inverse relationship between price and quantity demanded. Inverse means indirect relationship. There is a indirect relationship between the price and quantity demanded. When the price goes up, the demand for that commodity decreases, and when the price comes down, the demand for that commodity increases. Okay, and we can say that higher the price, lower the demand, and lower the price, higher the demand. So why I'm always saying that price will go, price will come, then only this will happen? This is because price is an independent factor. Price does not depend on demand, rather demand depends on price. When the price will increase, the demand will decrease. When the price will decrease, the demand will increase. So we can say that price is not dependent. Okay, price is not dependent on demand, rather demand will depend on price of that commodity. So law of demand is based on psychological tendency of a consumer. Psychological tendency, how? So it says that consumer will purchase higher amount of goods at lower price and vice versa. Okay, let us take an example of your father. When your father goes to purchase some vegetables from the shop, then he purchases, let us take an example of onion and let us take an example of onion and tomato. Okay, so the price of onion is rupees 50 for 1 kg, and price of tomato is rupees 30 for 1 kg. So what will your father do? This is the normal psychological tendency of any consumer, that when the price is more, then he will consume less of that commodity, which means that when the price of 1 kg of onion is rupees 50, then your father will say ki, okay, let us buy 1/2 kg of onion and 1 kg of tomato. Why? Because price of tomato is less than onion, so he will buy more of a tomato and less of that onion. Okay, this is the psychological tendency of a consumer. That's why you will see in so many stores that people bargain to purchase the commodities, okay, so that they can get goods in more amount of goods in less price. So we can say that price and quantity demanded are inversely related. So this statement can be expressed in mathematical term. So we can write that price is inversely proportional to quantity demanded, where P is equals to price and Q is equals to quantity demanded. So P is inversely proportional to quantity or Q. Fine. So this is what the law of demand says. Okay, so you must be thinking that when I was explaining you the definition or the law of demand, what it states, then I said one statement that other things remaining the same. What is this other things remaining the same? So द लॉ ऑफ डिमांड इज बेस्ड ऑन सम अजम्पशंस. ओके, सो वी नीड टू स्टडी दोज अजम्पशंस. सो दीज आर द थिंग्स विच आर referred here, that is other things remaining the same. So what are the other things? So we will take up them one by one. So first is, price of related commodity does not change. So price of the commodities does not change. If the price of commodity will change, then the demand will also change. Related commodity, which means that if there is tea and coffee, okay. So if the price of coffee is tea is rupees 10 and price of coffee is rupees 20, and when the price changes and tea is now of rupees 30 and coffee is rupees 20, remains to be rupees 20, then we will consume coffee and not tea. But before, when the price was same, like price were rupees 10 for tea and 20 for coffee, then we were consuming tea. Okay, so the price of related goods does not changes. Now next one is, income of the consumer does not changes. Okay, income, when income of a consumer changes, then the consumer moves to buy the goods, like more, they buy more of a goods, and when the income decreases, they buy less of that good. When the income increases from rupees 100 to 120, then they may buy 2 kgs of onion. Okay, they may buy 2 kgs of onion. Earlier they were buying only 1 kg, but as their income increased, they started buying more of the good. So income of a consumer should also be constant. Now next one is, taste and preferences, customs, habits and fashion of the consumer remains same. So if the taste and preference of the consumer will not change or will sorry if the yes if the taste and preference of the consumer will not change, then only this law will work. Otherwise, if there is change in the taste or preference or custom or habit or fashion in the consumers, then their demand will change for other goods when the price increases or decreases. Okay, so then in that case, this law will not work when there will be change in any of them. And the last one is, size of population remains same. So when the size of population changes, then also this demand won't work. So this law of demand will work when the population size also remains the same and does not changes. It should remain constant. Okay, so this is all about the law of demand. In next topic, next video, we will be studying demand schedule and demand curve. So that's all for today. I hope you have understood what I have explained. If you have any doubt regarding any topic or any word statement, you can comment in the comment box and then I will try to answer your questions. Okay, so thank you for today and stay safe, stay home. Thank you.